do or die on game day two of Group B at the 2016 Liga Sudamericana. The Bolivian champions Universidad San Simón take on Argentine League semi-finalists Weber Bahia Blanca. Both of these two trying to keep their semi-final hopes alive. Well, hola mis amigos y bienvenidos a Valdivia, Chile. Welcome everybody to the second set of games in Group B at the 2016 Liga Sudamericana, the Coliseo Municipal de Valdivia, the venue here in Chile. And my name is Tim Long, talking you through the action this evening. Two teams who both lost in their Group B openers on this court yesterday. San Simón of Bolivia lost to the hosts by just 8 points, 73-65. And Bahia Blanca losing to Hebraica Maccabi. And we will see those two teams in action in the second game on this court this evening. The two winners of last night's ties facing off to try and put themselves in top spot in those Group B standings. And here we see in front of us, first on court, the two losers from last night, looking to give their hopes of reaching the semi-finals a huge boost. We're ready for the official introductions of the two sets of players. San Simón, the Bolivian champions in the white and in the blue tonight. The Argentine National League semi-finalists of last season, Weber Bahia Blanca, lost by 6 in their opener against Hebraica Maccabi last night, shooting just 20% from the outside compared to the opponent's 38%. That was a huge factor for them. But a narrow defeat that will give them a boost and give them hope of being able to do something here against Universidad San Simón, who came into this group as the underdogs, despite being the Bolivian champions. They lost by 8. The damage for them really done in the first quarter, losing by 11, 20-9. They were dominated in the paint throughout the course of the game, lost the rebounding battle 64-42, and allowed their opponents 42 points in the lane. This is the second of the three games that these two teams will play in this group. Four different groups in the first stage of this competition, played in four different cities across South America. The top two of each four-team group will go through to the semi-final phase, which is another group phase, two groups of four. And the top teams in each group, just the winners of each group, will then go through to the best of five grand final at the end of November into the start of December. There's a look at your officials for the first game on court this evening. From Paraguay, Brazil and Venezuela. And we'll have a look at the two sets of players in a moment. Difficult to predict who will be the favourites in this one, but they will certainly, both teams, be desperately fighting for the victory to stay in the tournament. Here we see the Argentine roster, 23 points for Lucio Redivo in the game yesterday, although he shot just 7 of 23 from the field. Anthony Johnson was their other big scorer, a double-double, 17 points and 11 rebounds. And they also had 10 points and 3 blocks from Maximo Fayarup. And they're playing in their first international tournament. It is practically the same base of players that took them to the Argentine National League Southern Conference final last season. As we take a look at the starting five, Anthony Johnson there on the right actually shot pretty well for his team yesterday, 8 of 15 inside. And here we see the roster for the Bolivian champions, Universidad San Simón. Two players in double figures yesterday for them. Matt Glover had 18 points, although he was only 5 of 16 from the field. Lucas Tischer, 15 points and 9 rebounds, 6 of 9 from the field. They had three players on 9 points as well, although they didn't shoot particularly well. Diego Holguin, 2 of 13, and then John Cathy, 3 of 10. Shooting was a problem for them. Just 38% inside, 23% from downtown, and only 56% from the line in their opener in this competition. They will want their centre, John Cathy, to be a little bit more efficient, I think, inside in this one. Perhaps need him to be more efficient if they're to get the victory. Matt Glover there, 5 of 16 from the field, also had 5 turnovers and was fouled out of the game. And they'll need perhaps a little bit more discipline from him if they're to beat Sebastian Ginobili's team. Sandro Patino is the head coach for Universidad San Simón. His team have had the new addition of Lucas Tischer for this season. He's got experience at this level with Bauru and Malvin in Brazil and Uruguay respectively. But he's leading a team mainly of younger, inexperienced players, which makes San Simón the underdog in this group. And perhaps they'll have been buoyed by the fact it was just a single digit defeat for them against Valdivia, the hosts, on this court yesterday. And losing the first quarter by 11, they actually won the final three quarters then by 3 points. So he will want to make sure that his team get off to a good start. And they can't afford not to this time around. This is a tournament that's been dominated by Brazilian and Argentine teams since its inception back in 1996. A couple of decades ago, no other nation has come out on top. The last three titles have gone to Brazil, 2 to Uniceo BRB and 1 to Bauru. The last non-Brazilian or Argentine club to even reach the final was Agueda of Uruguay in 2013. What chance then for the Bolivian champion San Simón? Maybe a little bit more of an opportunity for Argentina's Bahía Blanca. The winner of this one will put themselves in the frame to finish in the top two in Group B and move through to the semi-finals. And those semi-final groups will take place at the start of November. The loser of this one here tonight, quite simply, will be done and dusted.
Repetir unas cuantas veces, cualquier situación que Maxi suba el balón, Juan Pablo suba el balón o Gastón suba el balón, Jamal, damos vuelta, bloqueo y pick and roll de Anthony. Tómense, primer punto, buen contacto en el bloqueo, usen el pick and roll, este va a la esquina, caída. Si no hay tiro, no hay pase, reversen para poner la bola adentro o jugamos del lado débil. ¿Estamos? Hagan esto bien hecho. Está ser agresivo de la primera jugada, si tenemos la posibilidad de anotar o pasar adentro lo hacen. Si no, revierto, alto, bajo o reverso por el otro lado. ¿Estamos?
This side or this side?
The side opposite, the two guys.
The one where you come, when you come in, just go straight into it.
Yeah. Okay. Here and they come here.
Estamos. Escuchen. Clave la defensa del balón. Presionamos y en un cuarto contener. No vayan desesperados a robar pelotas de la mano, no se llenen de pules y que no rompan con facilidad. Vamos.
Recuerden lo que hablamos de cortinar y recibir las cortinas. Vamos. 1, 2, 3.
Ahí.
Aquí, ya, para que haya el corte y la presentación al tiro del corte, ya. Después les recuerdo el movimiento triángulo, ya, ya, el pulgar, cortina, backpick, caída, y a partir del eje ves una acción. Puedes pedir una cortina de un puesto y jugar, ¿ok? Mucha defensa, chicos, mucha defensa. Agresivo en la defensa. 1, 2, 3,
¡Sansimos!
Final words from the two respective coaches for Bahía Blanca of Argentina and San Simón of Bolivia. And now the troops sent out onto the battlefield. Two sides desperately wanting to compete in the latter stages of the Premier South American FIBA basketball tournament. Juan Pablo Voilat there and Anthony Johnson. And Jamal Levy, who played 30 minutes yesterday, only took one shot and failed to hit it. Both of these sides struggled from long range in particular. San Simon 23%, Bahia Blanca 20% from the outside. Johnson and Tisha to compete the opening tip, and it's Tisha who puts it in San Simon hands. Glover. Chance to turn and face the basket for Cathy. Back out to the high post it goes. Cathy then trying to set the screen and the drive inside. Camargo had the ball knocked away, and here come Bahia Blanca. Mid-range pull-up, good. Positive start for the Argentines. And another turnover right off the bat for San Simon. Rowlett moves it on. Whelan trying to squeeze it through the gap for the big jam from Johnson. Bahia Blanca landing big blows early on. How about that from the big man? The double-double yesterday, the emphatic dunk to get underway here this evening. Tisha, he puts up the long ranger just inside and gets it to drop. First points on the board for San Simon. Gaston Whelan to bring the ball down court for Bahia Blanca. Moved on by Levy. Whelan again. Levy, time to shoot from the outside, too long. Offensive rebound though for Bahia Blanca, and they get the second chance opportunity. The basket for Faye Rupp that time. Old Gwynn. Camargo. Tisha, shot clock's already down to three here. That's a lovely pass from Tisha. And then the foul is Bahia Blanca. We're looking to block. It was Matt Glover making his way up towards the rim. Wiped out by Levy. Right in the final few seconds of the shot clock as well. Tisha hands it off on the perimeter. They'll try the three and they will get it to go. Diego Olguin. So it's Bahia Blanca by six, and they'll try and answer back with a three of their own. Voilette. It's a positive shooting start for both teams, despite their troubles yesterday. Tisha moves it on, quick pass again, and put in off the glass for Old Gwynn. Five early points for him. Bahia Blanca's lead cut to one again. They step into the paint, that'll be a travel against Gaston Whelan. After a really positive back and forth flow to the game, the jam early on from Johnson. Finally, these two sets of players get a breather. The travel called against Whelan. The first turnover in a while. Really well squeezed in by Matt Glover against the big frame of Johnson. San Simon have a lead. Fair up. Drive inside, knocked away from behind. Which way is possession going? It's to the Bolivians, much to the disappointment of Bahia Blanca, players and coaching staff. Tisha putting the ball on the floor against Johnson, looking to drive towards the baseline, spins towards the paint, the big block from Johnson. He's doing it at both ends of the court. And the foul then in transition. He had a couple of block shots. Anthony Johnson last night, as well as his double-double. That was the foul as Vaulette was coming up the floor. Corvalan, Vaulette. On by Levy, and it goes towards Johnson now. Back to the basket, up against Tisha. Turns, hangs, and can't hit. Rebound Glover. Matt Glover in towards the paint. Back out for the long two for Tisha. For a big man, he's got good range. So San Simon by three. Levy trying to play it in, picked off here by Olguin. And he's had it stolen right back off him by Levy. Back-to-back turnovers, back-to-back steals, and then the players hit the deck trying to battle for the basketball. Doesn't look like there's any real chance of that poor start to the game from San Simon that we saw last night against the host Valdivia. That was an unfortunate slip for Bahia Blanca and for Vaulette. And there you go, look at the shooting from San Simon, 5 of 6 so far in the game from the field. Johnson again inside, surrounded by 3 or 4 defenders, but somehow Bahia Blanca able to get on the ball. Shot clock still running down though, and the shot's not going to be away in time, is it? And the foul right at the end of the shot clock. It looked to me like it was about to expire. But the contact came, I think, just before the buzzer. So a fresh opportunity to score from the foul line for Bahia Blanca. And that'll be a big disappointment for San Simon to fail to grab the ball when they knocked it away from Johnson inside, and then to allow the opportunity to shoot right at the end of the shot clock and have to take the foul and give up the points. Just a 1-point game at the midway point of the first quarter. San Simon looking to extend it. Tisha moves it on. Quick step towards the baseline. Pass deflected though. And back into Bahia Blanca hands. Chance for them to take the lead. From the foul line, awkward looking shot, but he floats it in, Vaulette. And we're going to have a timeout call just over the midway point of the first. Vaulette getting Bahia Blanca in front, 6 points early on for him. And that forces Universidad San Simon to call time.
Estamos peleando a muerte cada posesión para que las regales, Chocó. A ver, un poquito, metete al partido. Vamos, hijo. En el 1-1, la primera que tú no puedes moverle, saca la pelota, vuelve a conseguir la posición, consigues espacio y puedes jugar ahí. Ya no seremos incisivos en ese tema. Matt, vuelve a jugar con algo más de sorpresa. La rojo, balón en mano, el doble stack, sale Chocó y podemos ver ahí una opción de gol. ¿Ya? Pero tiene que haber sorpresa, una parada y un arranque. ¿Ya? Ahora, si recibes el balón en mano, puedes irte en línea final también.
Lucas.
¿Okay?
Lucas en... Watch for the slip.
Okay.
If you said a good one, watch for the slip. You might have it right away for a layup.
Okay, I got you. Si Lucas tiene esta posición alta, juega alto bajo tú, hundido, yo. Aquí. Si Lucas está aquí, tú aquí.
Really entertaining first 5 minutes of this Group B match here at the 2016 Liga Sudamericana. Back and forth it's been. Several lead changes already in this first quarter. Juan Pablo Vaulet with 6 points already to match the 6 total he had in game one yesterday. It's his team, Bahia Blanca, who lead by one. Matt Glover. Twisting and turning and able to move it on to Olguin. Olguin in towards the paint. Back out it goes. Shot clock's down to 5 here. Cathy going to have to put up the 3. He was deflected and well wide of the mark. Well, off the back of the timeout as well. Not the best offensive execution. More space here for Bahia Blanca as they look to move it across to the far side. It was a poor pass from Hernan Jason. That was an opportunity to get the open corner shot. Last touch was off San Simon though. Shot clock down to 5. They're looking inside. Now they could go to the corner again. They take the shot early. There was still time. I think that's the question being asked by Corvalan to his teammate. Why didn't you move it on one further to the corner? Now into the paint. The finger roll. Awkward and no good for Camargo. A chance to run the floor. And a chance to score. Now the second attempt. Anthony Johnson left on the floor. And doing the business. Knocked away by Johnson. He's come into this one all guns blazing. Intense on defense. Efficient on offense. Commanding in the paint at both ends of the floor. Glover. Fisher, another long two. Too long this time. They'll bat it back, but straight into the hands of Corvalan. He looks to come down court quickly again. Can't cling on to it. Took a hard fall as well. Then they were short-handed on defense, Bahia Blanca, but stolen back. And here goes Johnson. Finally, some semblance restored as San Simon can come in transition. They can't finish, though. Jason. Over the top of the head, the pass. And Anthony Johnson is bumped. Or has done a bit of bumping himself as he moved towards the rim. Feet set in the paint from Tischer. And the shoulder from Johnson, too forceful. Universidad San Simon with just a mini drought. They'll try and end that here. It's another miss though. They started so well from the field. They've not scored in 3.5 minutes now. And here, Blanca aren't doing too much scoring though. It's only a 3-point game. They have a chance here though. Wide open for 3. Yes, the lead doubled to 6. And Facundo Corvalan. So now there's a danger for San Simon, who only scored 9 points, remember, in the first quarter yesterday. Gave them an uphill battle for the rest of the game. Finally, they stopped the bleeding. First basket in 4 minutes. It comes from Matt Glover. They certainly can't afford to let Bahia Blanca create a bit of breathing room over the final 2 minutes of this first quarter, the way they allowed Valdivia yesterday. Same spot. Different outcome though. The 3-pointer, Tischer grabs the rebound. Final minute and a half with Matt Glover in this first quarter. Tischer feeds it in this time, almost knocked away from Cathy, is able to recover. Backing in, up against Jason, back out to the perimeter. Long, long three, way off the mark from Matt Glover. Towards the end of the shot clock, but it's Not good composure on offense from San Simon and Bahia Blanca take full advantage. First basket for Francisco Fillipa. There's the three for Corvalan. Bahia Blanca bench, outscoring the San Simon bench 7-0. Final minute of the first, the lead is 6. They could do with a basket here. And yet struggles from the floor in the second half of this first quarter continue. Impressive in the first 5 minutes, San Simon. It has dried up in the last 5 minutes. Although they've got a chance off a turnover, and it's been turned right back. Corvalan the steal, can't get the finish. But there's teammates helping out. Third time lucky, still won't go. Bahia Blanca with the missed opportunity. They had three of them in transition, right underneath the basket. And San Simon had nobody back, and still Bahia Blanca couldn't get the score. And then the foul at the other end on Martin Fernandez. Just a 1 second differential between shot and game clock. Tischer with another long ranger, Lucas Tischer. That's three from long range for him, although all just inside. Final seconds of the first now. The defense from Olguin. As Jason was looking to put it up. And he's going to go to the line for two. Again, Tischer, just the toes of that right foot on the line. First one good. For him, 7 points in 14 minutes yesterday. Gets them both. And no chance to get the shot away at the end of the first. It's been a positive quarter, a high-scoring quarter for Bahia Blanca. They will be pleased with the job that they've done. They lead Universidad San Simon by 6, despite a very positive start from the Bolivians.
Son los tiros que tomó el 15, son los tiros que tomó el 5 porque queremos sacar la pelota en la mano. A ver si me entienden. Una cosa es la presión todo el campo y en un cuarto, controlar el balón. No es tan difícil. Controlar el balón. Y en ataque no la piques porque vos no podés picar la bola. Vos tenés que pasar. Ejecutemos bien la superioridad numérica y anoten. Y en juego de conjunto, está claro el juego, nosotros estamos jugando este pick and roll. No ataques el aro, salvo que esté solo. Si no, este cae, esto jugamos, y lado débil, o esto y esto. Simplemente eso, una sola bola, una sola cosa estamos jugando. Entonces háganla bien, una sola cosa, háganla bien. ¿Puede ser? Y sigan jugando de intensidad defensiva.
And there you see the game leaders, 6 points. A piece for the respective leading scorers, Lucas Tischer and Juan Pablo Vaulet. And a look at the team breakdowns, just briefly, the shooting statistics, which started so well for San Simon. And then they had that 4 minute drought, having hit, I think, their first five of their first six from the field. They need to make sure they stick with Bahia Blanca here in this second quarter. Here's Glover in towards the paint. Tischer wants the ball, gets it. on the foul line, knocked away. And the foul called against Whelan, I believe. In fact, it's Jason. First on him. Thought he could strip the ball there. Very nearly did. Cathy, shot clock down to 5 here. Cathy wants a bit of movement around him. Glover takes it off him. They weren't aware. They weren't aware of the shot clock. Matt Glover was looking right towards the backboard but didn't see it. So the turnover for Saint-Simon right at the start of the second quarter. A chance for Bahia Blanca to extend the lead. They look to step inside here, move it to the corner. The three right on the money for Fernandez. Lead stretched to 9 points, largest of the game. Olguin, this is really important for Saint-Simon now, that they stay within touching distance. Almost turned over. Camargo recovers, then looks to attack to the foul line. Back to Olguin. Olguin puts it up, moving across to his right. Awkward shot, and they'll come down court quickly. The rejection from Cathy, but almost straight back into Bahia Blanca hands. Just looks at the moment like the Argentines are getting stronger and stronger, and the Bolivians are fading. Nine points the differential. High catch and a lovely hesitation before the dunk from Tisha. 4 of 6 from the field, and that's his first close to the basket. Lead cut to 7. The foul has been called on the perimeter here against Glover by the looks of it. Lovely entry pass high towards the big man Tisha. Just this little hesitation here got the defence up in the air and rose to the rim for the simple finish. 8 points for him in the first half. Back to the perimeter it goes. Fist back inside. Good look at the basket. Wouldn't go. And then Tisha had the last touch. And you can see that there's a clear disappointment because he feels his teammate could have saved the ball on the baseline and let it bounce out. Little plays like that could make such a difference to the momentum in this first half. Saint-Simon just don't quite look at the races at the moment. So a chance still for Bahia Blanca to score. Won't go down though for Edivo. Glover. Can Saint-Simon come up with back-to-back baskets to close the gap? Tisha fires it in towards Cathy. And Cathy way off the basket, wanted a foul. And he's going to be hit with a technical. And he's furious. Cathy Macklin. Clear, you can see what he's saying, that he was caught by an elbow, but straight away the technical for the reaction. Saint-Simon in an important position in this second quarter, looking at the scoreline where they really have to keep their cool and try and execute. And look, he's getting riled and frustrated at the moment. John Cathy. The lead for Bahia Blanca is 8 points. Just 2.5 played in the second and still protesting his case after that missed shot on the offensive end for Cathy. Take a seat on the bench now. On this near side is Whelan. Whelan moving it on towards Johnson. The shot, good ball movement from Bahia Blanca, but it won't go down. Matt Glover. 18 points last night. Glover trying to find a way through into the paint this time and was fouled as he made his move. Saint-Simon having to do it without Cathy on the floor at the moment. Three personal fouls on Cathy already. Tisha. Back it goes to Biazaga. Across to the far side. Shot clock winding down again. It wasn't a good look. Contested. Long range two. Rebound Johnson. Fired into the edge of the paint now. Across to the far side. They're quick. They're lively. Bahia Blanca right now. They have the presence inside of this man. Anthony Johnson extends the lead. And for the first time, it hits double figures. 6 points for Johnson. Largest lead of the night. And you just worry for Saint-Simon at this stage because you feel that Bahia Blanca could pull away. Tisha handing it off to Glover. Look at that run, 19-6 in favour of Bahia Blanca since 6 minutes in the first quarter. The foul has been called on Camargo as Cathy still sits on three. Fernandez. They need to make a few positive plays here, Saint-Simon. Instead, it's the big man looking to make the positive play. Johnson, unable to finish this time. Glover, a chance to attack towards the baseline for Covarrubias off the bench, in towards Tisha. A little over-reliant on him in these opening 15 minutes, and that's a lovely move from Lucas Tisha. And he gets hit by Johnson and will go to the line for two. Second foul on Johnson. And that could be something that plays into Saint-Simon hands. If they can get Anthony Johnson in foul trouble. Here's a look once again at the incident involving John Cathy. There was a nudge out of the elbow by Jason. Cathy then having to be restrained after the missed shot. You can see the frustration, the tension so evident and plain to see. Saint-Simon know how big a game this is.
Yo quiero que juguemos el pick and roll. A ver, Lucio, si me entienden. Todo es para todo lo que jugamos. Pick and roll. Úsenlo para traer a este jugador. No le pasen a Anthony en velocidad. Que él caiga. Denle la pelota a Pancho, que tiene el tiro y este pase. Triangulemos. Es lo que nos está faltando en el juego. No en este partido, en el juego. Suma de pases. Y estamos otra vez pecando lo mismo. No pasamos la pelota. Tomen los tiros abiertos. Pero cuando se juega el pick and roll, no le pasen. Cuando están todos acá metidos en el medio, hagan un pase más para tomarte un tiro abierto. Vamos, vamos. Nada más. Pasen la bola.
Looking pretty comfortable at the moment, Bahia Blanca, led by the 6 points apiece for Juan Pablo Vaulet and Anthony Johnson, and another drought for Universidad Saint-Simon. There's disappointment all round for them. Just three players have scored for the Bolivian champions so far here. 8 points for Tisha, 5 for Olguin, and 4 for Glover. Tisha can't add one more to his tally from the line. He gets the second one though, and the number 99 has 9. And the lead is 9. Jason turning into the paint, faked the pass, drove all the way, couldn't finish. Here comes Glover at full flow, ran into the defense. The foul will go on Lucio Redivo. His first. Redivo, who was the leading scorer for the Argentines yesterday with 23 points. He's not played a great deal of this one. 5 minutes on court so far and yet to score. Non-shooting foul, so still San Simon ball. The three-pointer is good for them, for Vallezaga. It's a six-point game. Vallezaga with his first score. Ball movement around the perimeter for Bahia Blanca. Then they go inside. Lovely exchange of passes in the paint. And a soft pass back by the big man Johnson. Redivo with the finish. And he does now have his first field goal. San Simon trying something similar at the other end, but it doesn't pay off. And here come Bahia Blanca again. Into the paint once more. Bounce pass can't connect on the baseline from Fernandez. 4 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the first half. Bahia Blanca by eight. Got a touch along the way from San Simon, so Bahia Blanca still with possession and the attack right down the baseline. The finish for Whelan. Lead back to 10. Glover around the frame of Tisha. Looking back to Tisha in the high post. That's a lovely pass from him. And Camargo with the finish. Good offensive execution that time for San Simon. Bit of fluency to the attack, and off the back of that, the turnover for Bahia Blanca. So twice they've got themselves into double-digit leads, and San Simon have clung on. As Levy picks up his second foul, now a chance to make it a 6 or maybe 5 point game. 15 foul as well. Vallezaga high off the glass, doing a bit of window shopping. Axel Vallezaga. And another turnover, so we've got a 6 point game. In a flash, it's been cut down from 10. And Bahia Blanca with back-to-back turnovers. And Universidad San Simon with a chance to make it very close indeed. Camargo. Tisha. Looking to back in and go to work against Johnson. Into the paint. Forces it up and forces it in. He wants the foul as well. So San Simon now riding a wave of momentum. And a defensive stop at the other end. Bahia Blanca recover the ball though. Still plenty of time to work with. Into the paint they go. And then the foul. Tremendous play from Tisha in the high post. Look at this. And then powering in the paint as well. Having released Vallezaga just a few seconds earlier. Three unanswered field goals for San Simon when it looked as though Bahia Blanca were threatening to pull away. Maximo Feyeroop at the line. Just gets one of two, so it's a five-point game. Final 3 minutes of the first half. Glover. Very congested on this side of the court. They'll try and space it out now. Forced up. Oh, off the glass from the outside. The shot from Glover. And he still had 5 seconds to work with, but he threw it up. And everything falling for San Simon right now. It's a two-point game. Levy steps back behind the line. Tight pass to the near side, caught by Feyerup. Shot clock down to five now for Bahia Blanca. Great defense again from San Simon. Where has this effort come from? It's Glover across to the corner. And a whistle on the play as the ball reached Veizaga. In this near side, Matt Glover looks bemused by the call. Difficult to see from that shot. You can see the reaction from the coach and from the player. And Glover's been hit with a technical. Bahia Blanca just using that call from the official to momentarily perhaps slow the momentum of San Simon. The lead is three. Final 2 minutes of the first half coming up. Feyerup looking for Johnson again. Johnson back out to the perimeter. Good look for three. Won't go down for Levy. Out of bounds. It's going to be San Simon ball. Raulette, I don't think, has scored since the first quarter after six early points. Oh, picked off the inbound pass. Knocked away by Glover, recovered though on the baseline. Forced back. And they do an excellent job of keeping it alive before then trying to find Johnson inside, and he's fouled. Great work from Facundo Corvalan to come up with the steal off the inbound pass. And there's the jostling inside of Anthony Johnson and Lucas Tischer, the two big men. Tischer claiming there was an elbow from his opponent.
Explicarle que ellos antes de la intención de gol hay una intención de ir al contacto y eso es penado. Eso explicarle que no vuelva a ser porque había una acción real de gol.
Yeah, don't try to go there, see the foul.
Just yeah. Ahora no podemos entrar en pánico cuando tenemos un movimiento para salir. Matt, cuadras aquí. Lucas, Axel, Covacho y saca la pelota, Camargo, sacas Axel, Covacho. Pick central, generan espacio y recibes al eje. Y salimos. Axel, la carga física y luego la mano alejada. O sea, si no, esas pelotas tan fáciles no podemos perderlas, chicos. ¿Ok? Vamos bien, estamos bien, ¿ok? Vamos a cerrar de mejor manera. Dale, chicos,
Axel Veizaga has provided a spark for San Simon. They've been down double figures on a couple of occasions, but he's come off the bench to score 5 points. Tischer has 11 now to lead his team in the game. Before Veizaga got involved, only three players had scored for San Simon, all of them starters. And they looked as though they were going to be fading away in this first half. Anthony Johnson, 6 points and three rebounds so far. Not being quite as effective in the second quarter as he was in the first. Gives Bahia Blanca a four-point lead. Final 2 minutes of the first half. Here's Glover. Glover driving inside all the way through the defense. Somehow found a route to the rim. They're playing with an extra spring in their step now, San Simon. 9 points for Glover in the first half. Levy across to the near side to Corvalan, moved on into the big man Johnson. Johnson looking to back in and go to work against Tischer. Drew the double team but threw the ball away. Now in transition, here comes San Simon. Chance to run the floor, forced up. Off the glass, it won't go down. Feyerup the rebound. Approaching the final minute of the half. Levy the pass, space on this near side. Just got away from Johnson. He lost the handle on the ball when it looked like it was going to be an open dunk. San Simon with a chance to tie. It ricochets away from Tischer though. Crazy passage of play at the end of the first half. Knocked away and out of bounds And it's going to be Saint-Simon ball, so they'll have another chance to tie. Grimace on the face of Johnson, who got in for a big dunk early on in the game in the opening minute or so. Blazing play from Glover. Offensive rebound, Tischer, who got hit. Around 20 seconds differential between shot and game clock. Although the foul has been called on Vaulette. It was Tischer trying to rebound the ball. Looked like he could have got on Johnson. Lucas Tischer with a very impressive performance in this first half. Although he can't hit his foul shots. The first real opportunity for Saint-Simon to tie level since towards the very start of the game. And there's a turnover from Jamal Levy. Right off the back of those missed foul shots. So the chances for Saint-Simon to tie or take the lead stacking up at the end of the first half, having been down by double figures on a couple of occasions. Glover around the frame of Tischer, hangs from the foul line, wouldn't quite go down for him. Bahia Blanca able to bring the ball away. 5 second differential between shot and game clock at the end of the first. They've got to play hard defense now, Saint-Simon, as Bahia Blanca get away, across to the far side. Levy the high catch, but he tried to move it on to Johnson and just didn't have it under control. Is there an opportunity for a quick shot here for Saint-Simon? It's got to go straight up from Glover, and he didn't get it away in time. But what a fight back from Saint-Simon, having been down by double figures. It looked as though Bahia Blanca were going to open this Group B match wide open. But the Bolivian champions have shown their fighting character, and they have come back from the brink, sparked by Vei Zaga off the bench and the big play inside and in the high post as well from Lucas Tischer, as well as some blazing hot ball handling from Matt Glover. That's half time. Universidad Saint-Simon 32, Weber Bahia Blanca 34. Look there at the breakdown across the two quarters. An impressive recovery from Universidad Saint-Simon, especially in the second half of that second quarter. They've had a bad 10 minutes in the middle of this half, but outside of that, they've been pretty good. And just 13 points for Bahia Blanca in the second, having scored 21 in the first. A bit of entertainment arriving on court for the half-time interval. Do join us for the second half of this Group B game at the 2016 Liga Sudamericana here in about 10 minutes' time. Welcome back to the Coliseo Municipal de Valdivia in Valdivia, Chile. We're about to start the second half of the second Group B game for both of these two clubs here at the 2016 Liga Sudamericana. Both on the brink of elimination and need the victory in this game to stick with the top two in Group B and give themselves a chance of progressing to the semi-final stage. Just a two-point game. Bahia Blanca start with the ball in the third quarter. On to Anthony Johnson, who is impressive in the first half. Back to Jason. And he steps in and misses the shot. The rebound recovered by Camargo. Bahia Blanca up by double figures on a couple of occasions in that first half. And an incredible run over the course of about 10 minutes. That really put them in control. I think it was a 20-6 run for Bahia Blanca. And it looked as though there was going to be no recovery for San Simon at that stage. Nothing was going for them. But they sorted themselves out and they closed the gap and they closed it quickly. And here they are trying to tie. Tisha. Back to the perimeter now to Glover, who stepped towards the baseline. Shot clock's at two again. Tisha had to put it up and it was blocked. Nothing else he could do. Good look for three, but there's some tangling inside and the foul is going to be caught, I think, on Johnson here, is it? Johnson and Tisha not for the first time going toe-to-toe. Johnson being eased away. Threw back that left arm as he was being grappled by Tisha. And it's an offensive foul against the big man. And that's his third foul. And it comes in the first minute of the third quarter. But here come Bahia Blanca off the steal for an easy deuce. And it's the number two, Feyaroop. Almost another steal. They're in a good position here, San Simon. And if they can keep their composure. They lost the ball there and Feyaroop made them pay. Beizaga, who was a key part of their comeback in that second quarter off the bench, just had the ball knocked away. There's a look at the situation for San Simon. Didn't score in the final minute and a half plus of that first half, so it's now closing in on about 3 minutes without a score. And they lose the ball again. Glover had it knocked away behind the back. Out to the perimeter to Redivo. He'll fire the three and he'll hit the three. Nothing but net for Lucio Redivo. Bahia Blanca with another steal. And it's Redivo. Quick pass, quick finish. They're taking charge in this second half. The lead from two all the way up to nine. And there is no alternative but to call the timeout for San Simon. Redivo's three, right on the money. And then the same player coming up with a steal. Alert and effective on offense and defense, then the assist. Into the path of Gaston Wheeler.
Come on, man.
Salí por el eje de la cancha, Choco, tráetelo aquí, ya, y Camargo aquí, que salga solo por el eje de la cancha. No estén aquí para, porque provocan lado ayuda, ellos doblan, entonces tráiganselos aquí de mitad de la cancha para adelante y salí, aguanté el drible, entonces un poco más de cuidado, vamos más, ya, no puedes irnos el partido en un segundo si no se ha ido. Una vez que tengas el poste bajo, hundile, para no estar en apuro. Preferir buscar un foul, algo para que no tienes. Dale.
Safe to say that coach Sandro Patino's half-time team talk hasn't gone to plan here. San Simon fought back from a double-digit deficit to just 2 points down. And Bahia Blanca, in the space of just a few seconds, have made it 9 points again. San Simon without a score in the second half so far. Glover was visibly frustrated on the bench in that timeout, and he's just lost the ball, had it knocked away. Out to the corner, the three is good. Back-to-back threes for Redivo, double-digit lead. 12-point game now. And it's the largest lead of the game. Tisha closed down quickly by Johnson. Trying to recover on the baseline was Glover. And this is a 10-0 run for Bahia Blanca in the opening 2 minutes and change of the second half. John Cathy comes back in off the bench. Bahia Blanca 4 of 5 from the field this quarter. It's another three, not this time for Redivo. Batted back though into Johnson's hands, mid-ranger for him. No good, another offensive rebound and thrown out of bounds off the body of Cathy. They put themselves in such a good position, Saint-Simon, and it's just fallen apart for them in this third quarter. A chance to extend the lead, but a travel called against Jason. Another steal off the inbound pass. Feyeru down the baseline. Difficult layup wouldn't go. And then the foul in transition as Olguin looked to cross centre court. Olguin, who scored 5 points in the first quarter but hasn't scored since. They can't allow this deficit to grow, Saint-Simon. Not at this stage. Cathy calling for it. Able to receive it, high pass, attacks, but the block from Johnson picked back up and stuffed in by Tisha with authority. Ten-point lead. The offense has been free-flowing in these opening 3 minutes of the second half, though, for Bahia Blanca. Floater wouldn't go. Grabbing his own rebound was Johnson, trying to save it, then on the baseline, thrown back into the hands of Veizaga. A chance to make it a single-digit game again here for Saint-Simon. The three is way over the top of the rim, but caught. Across to the far side to Veizaga. He's going to fire the three and knocks it down. Axel Veizaga. And Saint-Simon just refused to lie down. So from 12 points down, it's now a 7-point game. Johnson. They'll try and answer back with a three of their own, and they get it. A dagger to the heart of Saint-Simon. Cathy fouled as he looked to turn and get into the paint. This is the follow-up play from Tisha. Great hands to reel it in. He's been consistent throughout. Lucas Tisha, 13 points, 6 rebounds, 3 assists, and a block shot as well. Veizaga couldn't link it with Tisha and turns it over. Inside they go towards Jason, turns off the glass, really well done. The lead is back to 12. Olguin into Cathy. He's had a really tough game. He gets that one to go somehow. Off balance, with the right arm outstretched. Flipped it in. That's his first score of the contest. Whelan. Across to the far side, they'll shoot another three, they will hit another three. Once again, it's Redivo, and he's hit a hat-trick of them in the last 5 minutes. 4 for 5 from downtown for Lucio Redivo. And another turnover for Saint-Simon. Here come Bahia Blanca again. It's Redivo once more. He is taking over. San Simon just can't protect the ball right now. It's 4-on-1 on the fast break. Feyer up with the finish this time. And once again a turnover. San Simon have fallen to bits. That must be about 4 turnovers in a row from the Bolivian champions. Let's see if Bahia Blanca can take charge this time. A whistle called on the plate. Look at the fast break points. 17-0. Look at the main score. It is now a 17-point lead for Bahia Blanca. It has been a disastrous third quarter for San Simon. Feira hangs on the foul line. Can't hit this time. Tisha with the rebound. Popped into the hands of Glover. Don't write them off just yet. San Simon showed their character in that first half and found a way back. Here's Glover. And they might have a chance of finding a way back if they can find a few like that. Glover's second from downtown. He now has 12 points. They need defensive stops though. Long two with Cathy coming out to close down the space on the perimeter. Glover to Cathy. Trying to force it as he spins towards the baseline. They wanted to travel Bahia Blanca. Again, it was a relatively awkward looking shot from Cathy. Wide, wide open three, too long. Jason trying to grab the rebound, was sandwiched between two. Fourth foul on Cathy, who has not had a good showing this evening. And he's going to take a seat again. 1 of 5 from the field. 4 fouls. Player up. And they turn it over, Bahia Blanca. Well, the game is not gone yet for San Simon, but they need a big 3 minutes here to finish the third quarter. Trailing by 14 as Levy picks up his fourth foul. And they just haven't been able to protect the ball. Lost count of the turnovers in this third quarter, but Bahia Blanca have turned it straight back. And then Tisha trying to release it down court, puts it back in the hands of the Argentines. In the corner here is Whelan. Now Feyerup attacking and driving into the paint and getting hit along the way. They make it 22 turnovers in the game now for Universidad San Simon. Plenty of those coming in this third quarter. They certainly need to find a way of protecting the ball better. They've turned it over again. Feyer up with the steal and with the finish. 12 points for him. The lead is 18. Here goes Glover, forced away from the paint, but a foul on Ariel Ramos. Bahia Blanca's largest lead of the game. Despite the best efforts of San Simon, the lead keeps growing and growing. Glover at the foul line hitting his first. He's got 13 points now. It's been a decent performance from him. 5 of 11 from the field. Makes it a 16-point game. Off-balance shot won't go for Vaulette. Camargo into the paint, knocked away. Corvalan across to the far side, wide open three, didn't take it, into Vaulette. Still plenty of time to work with on the shot clock. Not to Corvalan, move to the corner, this time they will take it. Vaulette can't hit, an offensive rebound and a fresh 14. Out of the mark with that three, Feyerup. You might have just caught the steal statistics popping up on the bottom of your screen. Bahia Blanca with 22 steals to San Simon's 5. Difficult shot, wouldn't go for Glover, but the offensive board for Tisha between two defenders. Tisha then drawing the contact as he went to try and put it in. He's looking on course for the double-double, potentially, Lucas Tisha, having fallen just one rebound short in the game here last night. 13 points and 8 rebounds so far this evening. In fact, make it 9. After that last one. Unable to make the foul shots though, and the lead for Bahia Blanca is still 16. The foul has been called on Tisha. Well no, it's an offensive foul, is it, against Ariel Ramos? Glover. Camargo towards the baseline, tried to flip it onto his right hand, awkward shot, wouldn't drop for Camargo. Final minute of the third now, quick pass, quick stop and pop, but wouldn't go down from the outside. Offensive rebound, Vaulette. The pirouette from Corvalan, back out to Levy. Redivo across to the far side, long two. Again, it won't drop, and Tisha grabs the rebound to complete that double-double. Glover, the long three, short. Trying to fly in and claim the rebound. It was Camargo, but Bahia Blanca quickly down court against the short-handed San Simon. Glover able to wriggle away all the way through into the paint, couldn't go coast to coast. Right back into the hands of Reizaga. Final seconds of the third, the lead for Bahia Blanca, still 18 points. And they come up with one more steal before the quarter is through. Third time lucky maybe. Not quite in time before the buzzer. Nevertheless, a commanding quarter for the Argentines, Bahia Blanca, who have poured in 26 points in that third quarter. Couldn't quite add a couple more right at the end, but there was contact. And it came before the buzzer. So Juan Pablo Vaulette just rubbing salt in the San Simon wounds at the end of three. A 2-point lead at half time has grown to 19 points at the end of three. Bahia Blanca leads 63-44. And look at the breakdown there. The third quarter, 29-12. The worst of the game for San Simon, the best by far for Bahia Blanca. The shooting percentage is pretty even inside and out, but look at the foul shots. Bahia Blanca getting to the line more frequently. and hitting more effectively. And the turnovers and steals have been very much key. 26 turnovers in the game for San Simon, 23 Bahia Blanco steals, and I would say probably half of those coming in the third quarter.
Presiona arriba y en un cuarto y en medio campo, control de balón, que no haya rompimiento.
Mission impossible, perhaps, for Universidad San Simón to find the comeback they need to remain in this competition. Very much facing the prospect of back-to-back defeats here in Group B, which would make it impossible for them to progress through to the semi-final stage. Weber Bahia Blanca after defeat yesterday on the brink of their first win to put them right back into contention. Glover. Camargo will fire the three right out of the gates at the start of the fourth. Maybe that's one route back into this game for them. Redivo moving it on. And away and out of bounds for a San Simon ball. So there's the opportunity to build a little bit of momentum at the start of the fourth. Camargo hit that three on the last possession. They'll try another three from the far side. Back-to-back threes in the first 30 seconds of the fourth. A lifeline for San Simon. Beizaga is 3 of 3 from downtown now, adding to the one from Camargo. It's a 13-point game. Can they get another defensive stop? Just to make it interesting here in the fourth. Good penetration from Vaulet that time. The crossover and the drive. Double figures for Vaulet now. Oh, they're going to keep firing from downtown, San Simon. Glover onto the left hand, finds Tischer, edge of the paint. And a foul called on Ariel Ramos, I believe. They're certainly not giving up on this one just yet, Universidad San Simon. It would have to be a monster quarter for them. Certainly not beyond the realms of possibility, though. Especially if Bahia Blanca are going to fail to protect the ball. Camargo, he's looking out to the perimeter towards Olguin. Pass was stopped. And here comes Vaulet on the trail to put it in. 17-point lead again. And then the San Simon turnover. The high pass was looking for Tischer. He'd moved the other way. And Bahia Blanca with back-to-back baskets. Ramos this time. And all of a sudden, once more, it's a 19-point game. Camargo, Olguin, they need a few more of those threes now, San Simon. Beizaga. Shot clock down to 6. It goes behind Camargo and away. Across to the far side for another turnover. Bahia Blanca in full flow here. The trail from Vaulet. Deadly on the fast break. And the second one there for Ariel Ramos, who only played 3 minutes last night. The coach able to get him a few more minutes on court this evening because of the differential between the teams. Bahia Blanco turning it over as frequently as Saint-Simon. The start of the fourth quarter, but they have a 19-point advantage, just 7.5 minutes to play. Glover looking for Tisha. The pass was too high, but reeled in by Tisha, who fires it from the corner. Still had 8 seconds to work with. The turnover straight back from Bahia Blanca. The pass down court, and they will finish that time. They're certainly not going to be hanging their heads and letting Bahia Blanca walk over them here in this fourth quarter. Redivo back to Corvalan, across to the far side. The three for Bahia Blanca. Missed the rim, grabbed by Olguin. Olguin onto the left hand, moving it on to Glover. Glover drew the double team. Long, long three. Rebound grabbed by Tisha though, fresh 14. They'll try another three here. Off the backboard, wouldn't go down. It was halfway down. Pop back out again. Onto the corner, Bahia Blanco with a three of their own. Tisha with another rebound. Camargo back to Tisha. Tisha will fire the long two, short. It's just a shootout at the moment. Redivo. Pace slows before they drive to the baseline. Tisha again off the backboard, able to grab it. This is Olguin. Gets it back on the near side. He'll fire the three and he's fouled on the three-point shot. It's a 17-point game. And Diego Olguin will go to the line for three. Again, this is still doable. Saint-Simon are sticking with Bahia Blanca just about. They are dangling by a thread, though. They need each and every point they can get as Olguin hits the first. 8 points, five rebounds in the game. He's 3 of 5 from the field. This is his first trip to the line, and he's making it look easy. Gaston Whelan in the game for Bahia Blanca. Olguin, 1 of 2 from the line last night. 3 of 3 on that trip. And the deficit has been reduced to 14, with still plenty of time to play. And we're going to have a timeout here as we approach the midway point of the fourth quarter.
Hay que acabar este partido con dignidad, ¿ok? Lo que les da resultados redondos es la presión. Más. La única situación es que tú salgas, desprendes de seleccionar por el eje la pelota. Aquí a veces está Camargo, despréndete de la pelota. Pass the ball, ¿ok? Ahora vamos a insistir con el Lucas al poste bajo, ¿ya? Le está defendiendo por arriba. A 45 grados y meten leyendo este lado ayuda.
Puede venir una cosa, si él me marca para la frente, alguien se presenta aquí, pase rápido aquí, rápido.
Para jugar
ahí, él va a estar en mi espalda, yo voy a estar de frente.
Hey, Camargo.
Great space, great space.
Presentate ahí para jugar el alto.
Hagamos esto ahora.
Fast.
Si es esto, juego mano en mano al lado contrario, Camay juega con respecto al balón y Ariel el pop-out. Escuchen. Es clave el balance defensivo. Después subo a defender. Balance defensivo y subo a defender.
A composed huddle for Bahia Blanca. Far more emotion from Saint-Simon and in particular from Lucas Tisha in that timeout. Confirmation of his double-double. 13 points, 13 rebounds here this evening. It looks as though his team are going to fall short though. They trail by 14. Bahia Blanca needing the timeout though to try and stop the momentum that Saint-Simon were building. They're trying to steal it here. They've got it back with Camargo. And off the back of the timeout, a turnover for Bahia Blanca. The three for San Simon wouldn't go down, and that would have really made it interesting. Olguin just off the mark. Corner three, put up, just off. Feyerup trying to grab the rebound. It ends up in the hands of Levy. Feyerup once more. Shot clock down to five. They'll fire another three. A little short this time, and here goes Glover. And he's hit hard before he could release the pass down court. He's looking to go behind the back. And Gaston Whelan jumped into him. I think Whelan was anticipating perhaps a pass down court. Long three, off the mark. Tisha trying to grab the rebound, just knocked away from him by Johnson. Whelan, 14-point game, final 5 minutes. Inside it goes to Johnson. And that is money for them. Glover to Tisha. Tisha faking the shot back to Glover. Lovely combination. 14-point game again. Now can they get a defensive stop? They're running out of time here. Moved on by Whelan. Feyerup. Across to the far side. And then the pass was looking for Feyerup. He'd gone the other way. Wonderful assist from Tisha. We've seen some really good playmaking skills from him this evening, as well as that double-double in scoring and rebounding. Here, Blanca blowing San Simon away on the fast break and from the bench. Dominant in those two particular statistics. So many turnovers from both teams. But points off the turnovers. Bahia Blanca well out in front. Oh, what a block that is! And then the missed dunk from Johnson. Still a chance to finish. Johnson again got away from him. And it's still going to be Bahia Blanca ball. The block, though, from John Cathy out of nowhere. Feyerup. The three is right on the money for Levy. And that cancels out the effectiveness of that big block from Cathy. They still get the score. The lead is 17 again with just 3 minutes to play. Here is Cathy on the offensive end. He's had a really frustrated evening, but that is one of the highlight reel plays of the game. And then he looks to attack and shoot against Johnson, who gets him on the wrist. Around 3 minutes to play. It looks as though Bahia Blanca have done enough to force this one over the line and to get the win that they need. Plenty more action coming your way at the 2016 Liga Sudamericana, though. Do stay with us for the hosts and Chilean champions, Deportivo Valdivia, against the Uruguayan champions, Habreca Maccabi. Put in off the backboard by Felipe. The lead for Bahia Blanca is 18. Off by Feyerup, another steal. Levy across to the far side. Feyerup pointing where he wants the ball to go. This is Redivo. Nice bounce pass, good hesitation from Levy, and a simple finish. 20-point Bahía Blanca lead. After their 6-point defeat against the breaker Maccabi last night, they were on course for their first win at this tournament and back in contention for those top two places in Group B and the opportunity to advance into the semi-finals. There's the composure in the paint from Jamal Levy. It should be a really interesting contest next up on this court between the Chilean and Uruguayan champions. Both won against these two teams yesterday. The winner of that next match here on this court will be guaranteed a place in the semi-finals. Levy on to Whelan. Fired back in towards Levy. And he's hit in the paint and will go to the line for two. He's gone about his business quietly this evening. Jamal Levy. 5 points, 4 rebounds, and 3 steals in the game. Some of those steal statistics are quite frightening from Bahia Blanca. 8 steals for Maximo Feyeroop, as well as 12 points. And the potential for a double-double in points and steals if he can muster up a couple more in the final 2 minutes. Quarterback pass can't link up with Camargo. Corvallen. Final minute and a half. Here is Feyeroop. Across to Levy. Fired in by Redivo. On the turn, it won't go for Fayipa. Graphic just drawing your attention to 7 turnovers from Camargo, but there's plenty to blame in that department for San Simon. A number of players who haven't protected the ball well enough. I make it 9 turnovers for Olguin, 8 for Glover. Final minute of the game, off the mark for Feyeroop. The lead is 19 points for Bahía Blanca of Argentina. Here's Glover, in towards the paint and felt. We've had a couple of little rallies from San Simon, suggesting that they were willing to fight for their position in this tournament, but they have just lacked the quality and composure that Bahía Blanca have shown. And they've had 4 players hit double figures in scoring, led by this man. 16 points after 18 yesterday. And to add one more to his evening's tally. Fernandez knocked away. A chance to come in transition on the fast break. Glover backs it in, and a chance of a 3-point play for Glover. And a chance to hit 20. We're into the final seconds of the game, though. The job is well and truly done for Weber Bahía Blanca. And it's going to be the end of the line in this tournament for the Bolivian champion San Simon, who will play one more game, although they won't be able to progress now to the semi-finals. They will take on a breaker Maccabi in their final matchup. going to be a big one for Bahía Blanca in their final matchup. They're about to go 1-1. And they will take on Deportivo Valdivia in their final game. Valdivia 1-0 so far, but could be 2-0 or 1-1 by then. I do remember that matchup between Deportivo Valdivia, the hosts of this Group B, and the Uruguayan champion Sabreca Maccabi is coming up shortly after the conclusion of this one. Shot clock turned off at the end of the game now. 15-point lead for Bahía Blanca. The three-point attempt is well off the mark, and that will do it. The first win. Now the 2016 Liga Sudamericana for Bahía Blanca as they keep themselves in contention for a place in the semi-final. It's the end of the line for San Simón of Bolivia. The Argentines get the victory in game two. And now have it all to play for in terms of trying to advance to the next stage. Led by the 17 points of Redivo, who did the damage with his outside shooting in the second half. 4 of 5 from downtown. They also had double figures from Vaulette with 13 and Feyerup with 12. Some big defensive games. The 8 steals of Feyerup is one of the stats that jumps out from the box score. They were energetic, alert and lively throughout, and they have done everything they needed to do to overcome that 6-point defeat to Hebraica Maccabi last night. It is Bahía Blanca who take it over San Simón 78-63. That third quarter did the job, didn't it? 29-12, having led by only 2 points at half time. They put themselves in an insurmountable position, ready for the start of the fourth quarter. There was really no chance of coming back from that for San Simón. As we take a look at some of the numbers here, Bahía Blanca able to win the rebounding battle, twice as many assists. And the shooting numbers, pretty even, in fact, although look at how many attempts Bahía Blanca took inside, 55 to San Simón's 37. And we've already seen the rebounding and assists statistics, but impressive numbers for Bahía Blanca in terms of steals. And disappointing turnover count for both teams, but the steal stands out there. 26 steals for Bahía Blanca to the 10 of San Simón. The game leaders then, 20 points for Glover, the highest scoring in the game, but Redivo, who was very quiet indeed in the first half, then lit up the arena in the second. 4 of 5 from downtown in that spell in the third quarter when Bahía Blanca really pulled away. He led 3 players for them in double figures. Vaulette with 9 rebounds, Tisha a double-double for San Simón, with those 13 rebounds to add to his 13 points. Glover was fouled out in the end with his game-high 20 points and 7 rebounds. The final score, Universidad San Simón 63, Weber Bahía Blanca 78. Do stick with us because in a few minutes' time, we're going to have the Chilean champions and hosts here, Deportivo Valdivia, taking on the Uruguayan champions, Hebraica Maccabi.
dos, tres.
María.